Hey, y'all. Dan.
Hey. Yeah.
Did you want a drink?
Please.
Okay. Our waitress here is going to bring him a drink. And look, it's Ginger St. James,
everyone. Look who's here.
Back on the show. Ginger, welcome.
Can I stay a bit?
Yeah, absolutely. Ginger's going to sit in with us as the Creeping Bent Orchestra. Hey, you remember, you like Janet, our reporter?
I love Janet.
Janet is our favorite.
Janet's the best.
So I think we're all ready for more Janet, so let's go to see Janet right now.
Hello there, Janet again, in Janet Tidbits. I just felt I would talk about my cats. I have had, in the 30 years of marriage, I'd had up to 8 cats. Currently I have 2, Joyelle, Star, and Nikki Noel. Yes, they're my teenagers, but there are 3 cats that stick out in my mind. I had Lucky. Lucky was given to me as my wedding gift. He was bright orange and white, gorgeous cat, and he was a wonderful cat. They told me he would never live to, and I called him Lucky. There was Katrina. Now today, March 11, 2016, marks her 5 years. She's on the Rainbow Bridge waiting for me to come and join her. There's also, on top of that, we have Joyelle Star, which I have in the house, along with her brother, Nikki, who is a teenager this year, 2016. So I just thought, like, to inform you that if you have a cat or a dog, please take time to take care of your pet. The pets in your home are family. They need your hugs. They need to have you there for you. They want to go for a walk? Take Fido out and take him for a walk. If a cat needs a hug, be there for him or her, because they were going to be there for you. If you need help, they'll be there to help you. And as I say, Katrina was a calico, Joyelle's a carat, and Nikki Noel, he is a silver tabby. So I want to thank you again, and I hope you have a wonderful night. This is sign off, Janet from Janet Tidbits.
Bit of Janet, some great stuff. Her cats.
Cats.
Yeah, her cats. I know. Shane doesn't like cats.
Cat.
Dog.
You
all right? Shane has a pet.
You stuck record there. Eh?
I know. That's what happens. I go into a trance.
So Hamilton, this is an opportunity for you all to be able to advertise on the Cadillac Bill Show, but not just regular advertising, I'm talking about subliminally advertising. Yeah, so this is the most effective form of advertising. It's been proven. You just show one frame. See, now that frame was Chuck's aluminum siding. And here is the actual graphics of what that flash was. And you now are interested in Chuck's aluminum siding because you saw a flash of the frame.
Even if you don't have a house.
Yeah. Everyone needs aluminum siding. How about, okay, let's try this again. That, okay, let's see it in longer now. Tina's babysitting service, eh?
How would you know you needed a babysitter until you saw
that? I know, that's right. So
I don't even have kids and I need one.
So everyone now wants to contact Tina to get her babysit So anyone, local people, this is just a cable show, so local people can subliminally advertise on the Cadillac Bell Show, $20 per frame, and we'll show it, just like that. And $20, and it's the most effective. It's proven to be the most effective.
Yeah, it's proven that the subconscious actually takes in that much.
Much more. Okay, let's try this again. That, okay, you know what you saw. It was only a second, but you know very well. Dino's auto detailing and tinting.
Dino's auto detailing and tinting.
My phone is ringing off the hook right now. Yes. To get their car detailed.
So, by the way, these businesses don't exist. We are just, these are examples of, if you've got a detailing and tinting business, you can subliminally advertise on the Cadillac Bill Show. Ginger, you have a little business. You're walking dogs, don't you?
Walking little dogs.
Ready? Oh, yes, okay. Yeah, you saw that. You're now interested in Ginger's.
Now you want your dog walk by me.
Let's see it longer now so the audience can really.
I'll take them out and I'll play with them and I'll walk with them down the street and I'll take care of them and feed them. It's excellent.
So there you go, Ginger.
Look at that.
You owe us $20.
I do.
Because we just flashed.
And more.
No, seriously, $20 now.
$20.
Plus tax.
So, Ginger, we'll let you be on that. We'll give you that flash for free. Okay, so there you go. See how effective this is? Folks, advertise on the Cadillac Bell Show. Subliminal messaging really works. And we're proof of that. Right? I think we're proof of that.
I hope so.
It's the most effective.
I owe you $20.
It's the most effective way. Okay, so Ginger's dog cleaning. Ginger's dog aluminum siding and detailing.
And tinting.
No, seriously, you do walk dogs, don't you?
I do, yeah.
No, we're not making this up. This isn't a joke. So, call her. Give her a call.
Call him, and he'll call me.
Even if you don't want any dog walk, just call her to say hi. Call her at 3 in the morning.
I love it, yeah.
Whenever you get back from the bar and you're drunk,
give Ginger a call. We'll put my address at the end of this episode, and you can ring my bell. Yeah.
No, here's her number on the screen. Call that number, 3 in the morning. She loves hearing from drunk people when they've
late night twister.
After last call.
Late night twister, naked.
Naked late night twister.
Wow.
It's fun at my house.
Hey, okay, we've got to get to our reporter now. Our reporter in England, Dom Chambers, and let's see what he's got for us.
Hi Bill, this is Dom, and we're in the historic city of Wells, and just behind me here is the Bishop's Palace. Extraordinary to think that bishops lived in residences that had moats and defensive qualities. You can see the battlements, and that's a testimony to the power of the church that they held here in England in medieval times. In front of us we've got these swans, and just around the corner here is a bell. And if the swan are feeling hungry, they go and ring the bell, which I think is rather charming. Apparently they actually do this. I've always thought that swan are rather intelligent creatures, and that's a testimony to that. Fans of Blackadder, if you've ever seen Blackadder, might know the character, the baby-eating Bishop of Bath and Wells. Well, there is a Bishop of Bath and Wells. We don't know if he eats babies or not. I think it's rather unlikely on the general face of things, but the Bishop of Bath and Wells lives right here through this gate. For the Cadillac Bill Show, this has been my pleasure as Dom, History Man in Wells.
Thank you, Dom. Great stuff. Bishop's Palace. The Bishop's Palace. How would you like to live in the Bishop's Palace?
Oh, I would live there all day.
You could
and
be,
every day.
You're Bishop.
For the rest of my days.
You could be Mrs. Bishop.
I would be Mrs. Bishop.
And living in, you'd be the lady of the palace.
Mrs. Bishop Palace.
and the swans, eh?
Yeah,
remember what they do when they're hungry?
I would ring the bell myself, too.
You'd be ringing the bell.
I'd be ringing the bell. I'm hungry.
So folks, Dino's auto detailing and tinting, just an example, you too can advertise subliminally on the Cadillac Bill Show. Who's our favorite reporter?
Paul
Kovac and his dead bodies. Let's see what he's got for us now, eh?
Hey Bill.
Hey Bill.
So Paul and I
We're back on an expedition of Hamilton, finding where more of the dead bodies are. And we're back at Gage Park. You'll remember we were here last year, and there's way more bodies here that you found. Is that right, Paul?
Well, I found some in a place where the average person wouldn't expect. Right underneath this band shell. And they don't know they built this on top of graves.
Now any band in Hamilton knows this grandstand well. My band's played there many times, and it's right over burial plots of ancient human beings. Now, how old were these graves, do you think?
Oh, I'd have to get my pendulum for that.
Okay, I'll tell you, get your pendulum out, see if you can find anything in this general area. Give it a shot. We're actually behind us.
Here we go.
Oh, we found one. Is that one?
Yeah, they're buried that way. So let's see what we got here. Just give me a second. And there's another plot right there. Let's see how far back this goes and how far it goes this way. Okay, two, three.
By the way, folks, right now what's going on is the powwow. Natives, every year they have a powwow. It's like a festival or a dance of some sort.
Here's the other corner, 35 yards.
And would this have been a wooden church?
More than likely it would have been wooden. Depends upon the year, really.
Okay, now let's find one more plot, one more body, and we're going to find out the year it was buried. Do you think you can manage that?
Certainly.
Okay, so he's found something. Paul, what have you got there? He's just asking his pendulum to himself. He asked the pendulum yes or no questions. The pendulum says yes or no, and that's how he finds the date of the person buried here.
Just give me a minute, Bill.
Okay. You see, this kind of thing can't be rushed. We believe in accuracy. We believe in thoroughness on this show. Investigative journalism. And when we give you a date, you can be sure it's the date. It's the actual date.
This is all taking place on July the 13th, 5 p.m.
Okay, Bill. This church was built here 25 yards by 35 yards in shape. And this church was erected in 1782 and torn down in 1841.
That's amazing. So while we're enjoying the native powwow, we're also doing a bit of scientific research here as we're, Paul is scouting out to find out if there are any human remains buried right below our feet. Did you find something?
Right here. Oh, they're everywhere in this park. Two, three, four. Okay, and there's another plot.
Okay, a body, right?
Yes, these are all bodies. Okay. 1817, right here, is when this person was buried here.
Hey, ask if it's a male or a female.
Oh, that's easy as pie.
1817, and it is a...
It was a male.
All right, so I would say we're going to let the festival carry on. I think we're going to head back to the studio now. So anyway, this is a Cadillac, Bill, at the Native Powwow, National Aboriginal Day, in Hamilton at Gage Park. Back to you, Bill, in the studio. Thanks, Bill. Great stuff. Nothing like dowsing for dead bodies during a festival.
It's crazy, Bill. I'm always reminded of that musical question. It's like, everywhere we go, people want to know how dead we are. And he's got all the numbers.
He's got the exact numbers.
The exact numbers right now.
He's absolutely exact. Yeah, I thought that was fascinating. And it was also nice to see, hear about the natives, too, in the powwow.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, we didn't hear much about them, but, you know, they were there.
They were there.
They were there. We saw
they
them.
They were there.
So, we have two birds with one stone. finding dead bodies and learning about Canadian heritage, our ancestry.
Mm-hmm. Was there four churches?
Four churches right there, and 100 dead bodies under the grandstand,
the band shell.
Where you played.
Yes.
Where we played.
Yes. Yeah, you played there a lot.
Yes, so many, many times. Too many to count.
I can't even.
Many times.
On one hand.
So we've got Ginger here with us. A wonderful, talented, beautiful Ginger. And I think we're about winding down. And we have a special surprise for you, Hamilton. We recorded a song called Shortening Bread. And we did a little music video for this. The whole Creeping Bent Orchestra in it, and Ginger. And let's see, now, I taught them this little dance. Do you guys remember the dance?
I remember this part.
Yeah, you start with reach out, and then you reach up to heaven.
Oh, right.
Right.
And then you cross
then
your arms.
Then you cry.
Oh, yeah, the cry, okay.
So you folks at home, when you're watching the Shortening Bread, you can do this yourselves at home, the dance. Reach out.
The dance.
You all stand up in your living rooms. Reach out.
Then reach out.
Reach up to heaven. Cross your arms and cry. There you go. So it'll be fun for you. You guys all get your dancing shoes on and your leotards. And have some fun with this.
He gets our white gloves.
You can do it naked too.
Yeah, absolutely. We advise that. It's better naked.
The foot moves are pretty self-explanatory.
Yeah. You'll figure them out.
Yeah.
So I think we're wrapping it up. We're saying good night, Ginger.
Good night.
Thanks for being on the show with us. And Downton Abbey. Stick around after the credits. Another episode of Downton Abbey. Lady Eat It gets a new frock.
Oh.
So that's something. That's
a beautiful frock.
Yeah.
Burlap and everything.
Yeah. Mm. Something to look forward to. Ooh. So here we go. Say goodnight to everyone, Ginger.
Good night, everybody.
Night, Hamilton.
Put on the skillet, put on the lid. Mom is gonna make a little shortening bread. And that's not all she's gonna do. Mom is gonna make some coffee too. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Three little children lying in bed, two were sick and the other most dead. Sent for the doctor, and the doctor said, give those children some shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening. When them children laying in the bed heard that talk about shortening bread, they popped up well and started to sing, jumping up and down doing the pigeon wing. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Slipped in the kitchen, picked up the lid, filled my pockets full of shortening bread. Stole the skittle, stole the lid, stole that gal making shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Caught me with the skittle, caught me with the lid, caught me with the gal making shortening bread. Whip for the skittle, whip for the lid, and 6 months in jail eating shortening bread. Mama's little baby loves shortening. Mama's little baby loves shortening bread.
Richie, my lad, are you beginning to see a future here then?
In a way, this latest business has forced me to recognize that I do want Downton to be my future.
I'm glad.
At least we can comfort ourselves that this old box will forever be here, because we saved it. Until it rains, that is.
Right you are. Jolly good. Jolly good.
Mother, why is Edith having a new dress and not me?
Because it's Edith's turn, dear.
Can it be my choice next time?
Of course, darling Harry. As long as you choose what I choose.
I don't know why we bother with fittings. We always get the same frock.
And made from the same piece of scrap material found in the dustbin.
Oh, Father, the only one who never sticks up for me in all of this is you. Why is that?
If I had made my own fortune and bought Downton for myself, it should be yours without question. But I did not. I am a custodian, my dear, not an owner.
So I'm just to find a husband and get out of the way?
You could stay here if you were married to Matthew.
Oh, Father, I'd never marry any rat that I was told to. Come on, Spot.
Oh, crumbs. Oh, dear Harry, what is it now?
You heard him? Matthew this, Matthew that, Matthew, Matthew, Matthew. Oh, Mother, don't you see? He has a son now. Of course he didn't argue with the inheritance. Why would he when he's going to get all the wood chips and cheese? I wish you'd just admit it. I'm a lost rat to you. I took a lover with no thought of marriage. A mouse. Think of that. A scurrying little mouse. Oh, dear. And not even an English mouse.
Oh, Mrs. Huge, is there anything more thrilling than a new frock?
I suppose not, m'lady.
Such lovely fabric.
But, hey, whatever's holding Edith up?
She's trying on her new frock.
Let's try this on for size.
A perfect fit.
Delicious scraps, Countess Greyland.
Naturally.
Where's Edith?
Good evening, everyone.
Aye, Crumba.
Whoa!
Aye. Crumbs. Good Lord, what are you wearing?
Oh, you modern girl. You're so 1914.
About a sing-along. Something fun and you can all sing along at home.
Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had some chicks, E-I-E-I-O. With a chick, chick here and a chick, chick there. Here a chick, there a chick, everywhere a chick, chick. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had some ducks, E-I-E-I-O. With a quack, quack here and a quack, quack there. Here a quack, there a quack, everywhere a quack, quack. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. Old MacDonald had a farm, E-I-E-I-O. And on this farm he had some turkeys, E-I-E-I-O.
with a gobble gobble here and a gobble gobble there. Here a gobble, there a gobble, everywhere a gobble gobble. Oh, MacDonald had a fun, E-I-E-I-O. E-I-E-I-O. By his side, mm-hmm. He rode right up to this mousie's hall. Mm-hmm. He rode right up to this mousie's hall where he most tenderly did call.
Mm-hmm. He took this mousie on his knee. Mm-hmm. He took Miss Mousie on his knee. Pray, Miss Mousie, will you marry me?
My Uncle Rat's consent. Mm-hmm. Without my Uncle Rat's consent, I wouldn't marry the president. Mm-hmm.
And Uncle Rat gave his consent. Mm-hmm. Uncle Rat gave his consent, and that's the way that marriage went. Mm-hmm.